Y'all, welcome back to another video. I'm your boy Jay Bird, aka Mr. Cool Guy, and with today's video I'm reviewing J Lo's sixth album that came out when it was the year 2007, called Brave. I gotta say, this album is such a classic. It's good I got to check this album out when it was the year 2013, and I gotta say, this is a classic album that she did to follow up on her fifth album, which was her first ever Spanish album in English, called How a Woman Loves. But with this record, it's got like 13 tracks on the record and two singles off the album, such as Do It Well, Hold It, Don't Drop It. And this album do like a lot of pop and R&B. And the album debuted at number 12 on the charts, and it went 2x platinum in Russia. And we're gonna get into like all 13 tracks on this sixth album by Jennifer Lopez, called Brave, starting with track 1, Stay Together. Here we go, guys. Enjoy. Sorry about that. That song, track 1, Stay Together, I really feel that song. It's pretty dope, and she did her thing with that song. It's do got like a lot of pop and R&B and a little bit of dance. And You Walk the Tumble, like, what y'all like about that track? Is that one of the interesting songs that she did to begin the record with or not? Please share, because I really think it is, though, and it's a banging joint. That's all I can say about track 1. All right, moving on, track 2, Forever. Here we go, guys.
Just ain't enough days in a week.
say track two, Forever. I actually feel that joint, and it's a banging joint. It do got like a lot of R&B, soul, and pop coming together, and I really feel her voice and those melodies coming together with how she singing the verses. And that is a unique joint to listen to on the record. And you all could tell me, like, we all like about track two. Is that one of the unique joints on the record that she did or not? Please share. Or is it one of the bangers to listen to while playing the record? Let me know your thoughts. All right, moving on. Track three, single off the album, Hold It, Don't Drop It. Here we go, guys. Drop It. I actually feel that song. It's got like a lot of disco and funk coming together. And I don't know if I've seen the video, but I might have to check the video because I did my research. When she did the video, it was more like she was sitting on a disco ball and she had male dancers in suits, I guess. And she was pregnant at that time with Mark Anthony's twins, though. But you all could tell me, like, we all like about track three. Is that one of the interesting songs that she did off the record with all that disco funk coming together with that song? And it makes you, like, want to listen to that song in a club or at a party or whatever. Let me know your thoughts, because it sucks that this song didn't get enough shine to be a single off the album. But you all can let me know what y'all think of it in the comments below, what y'all like about track three. Moving on, track four, single off the album, Do It Well. Here we go, guys.
Do it, you're doing it well. gonna need a little privacy. I don't wanna do the dance, no, don't see y'all. Need a one-woman man 7 days a week. Quit trying to play a cool boy, make you move. I told you how it is, nothing to lose. You just staring over here all like a breeze. Now I ain't taking cash or credit, just a guarantee. There ain't nobody else but me, boy.
You ain't even trying to play me, boy. You're so good, and you're so fine.
You know me, say it.
I gotta say, track 4, Do It Well, I really feel that song, and it do got like a lot of, hip hop and pop music coming together, and disco. And I say that is an interesting song that she did off the record, and it's good that this song received positive reviews from music critics and fans, and it reached the top 14 in the top 14 and 17 countries though. And I didn't see the video though, but I might have to check that out though. But y'all could tell me like what y'all like about track 4, Do It Well. Is that one of the dopest songs that she did off the record? You know, she sampled one of the members of the Temptation song, Eddie Kendrick's song, Keep On Truckin'. Let me know your thoughts on how good that track is to you guys. Alright, moving on, track 5, Gotta Be There. Here we go, guys. She sampled one of Michael Jackson's songs called I Wanna Be Where You Are when he was a little young in the 70s. And I say I really feel that beat, and it's good that she added a few background vocalists from the King of Pop, which was dope. And y'all could tell me like what y'all like about track 5. Is that one of the dopest songs that she did on the record? Y'all just feel that bass and y'all feel all that pop and R&B come together with her vocals and her melodies. Let me know your thoughts. Alright, moving on, track 6, Never Gonna Give Up. Here we go, guys.
Forgive me, kid.
track 6. That song was good. I really felt the soul and R&B with a little bit of pop funk coming together with that song. And I'd say that song is interesting though. I actually dig it though, even though I didn't really check the song out a long time ago, but you guys can let me know what y'all like about track 6. That one of the best songs, or one of the interesting songs that she did on the record. Let me know your thoughts on how good it is to you guys. Alright, moving on. Track 7. Mile in These Shoes. Here we go, guys. Say track 7, Miles in These Shoes. I really feel all that electric dance music coming together with rock, and she did good with that song. And I actually think it's interesting though, even though I didn't really check the song out a long time ago though. But y'all can let me know like how good that song is to you guys when y'all listen to this album. Please share. Alright, moving on. Track 8. The Way It Is. Here we go, guys. Track 8, The Way It Is. That song was interesting though. I really feel all that pop, R&B, and Latino come together with that song. And you know, I ain't really paid attention to the song back then, though. I say she did go with that song. I really feel that bass and that beat is just so hardcore, and I really feel her melodies and her unique singing voice with that song. Y'all can tell me, like, we got like about track 8. Is that one of the best songs that you ever heard on the record? Or y'all just like that she did her thing with how that song turned out when she released the record in 2007? Alright, moving on. Track 9, Be Mine. Here we go, guys. Feel that song. It's got like a lot of hip-hop music coming together with pop and R&B. And I say she did good with that song. It's a amazing joint, and I did heard the song back in 2013, though. But you all can tell me, like, we all like about track 9, Be Mine. Is that one y'all favorite joints off the record? Or y'all just like that song is so iconic, makes you like want to listen to the album over and over? Please share. Alright, moving on. Track 10. I Need Love. Here we go, guys.
I might have been mischievous.
gotta say, track 10, I Need Love. I really feel that song. It's got like a lot of hip hop and R&B and soul coming together. And I gotta say, she did good with that song. You know, she sampled that song from Bill Withers, a song called Use Me. And I gotta say, she did do good with sampling a few lyrics from his song from the 70s. And that, the song is pretty good, though. I really like it. And it's good I got a chance to check that song out when it was the year 2013 when I reviewed this whole entire album. And you all could tell me, like, what y'all like about track 10. Is that one of the best songs that she done on the record? Or is it one of the interesting songs that y'all heard on the record? Let me know your thoughts. All right, moving on, track 11. Wrong When You're Gone. Here we go, guys. Like all that R&B, pop, soul, alternational R&B, including Chernobyl music and Bald coming together. And it's good that Carrie Hilson co-written this song for her. And I know, like, she ain't the only one that's singing this song. It's some background vocals from Carrie Hilson, because I recognize Carrie Hilson's voice in the background, though. And I gotta say, it's a interesting song, though, and it's good I got a chance to hear the song when it was 2013. And I really like that Carrie Hilson co-written this song, and I know she did her own demo version of the song called Wrong When You're Gone, which is excellent. And you all can tell me, like, what y'all like about track 11, Wrong When You're Gone. Is that one of the best songs that y'all heard on this album that's so romantic, that's about love, and about getting back with someone that you really in love with and that you was wrong for when they left or whatever? Please share. All right, moving on. Track 12, main title of the album, Brave. Here we go, guys. I really like it though. It's got like that neo influence in this song with the song with his song called Because of You. It has that same flow that he did with that song back in 2007. And I gotta say this song is too good though. I really like it. It ain't really that bad though. And I really like that she did a song to the main title of her album Brave. And the song do like a lot of dance, pop, R&B, a little bit of rap bass in the beginning, so you got like that a choir vocal beat at the beginning, and I really like that electric pop R&B hip hop electro clash and even electric. And y'all can tell me like what y'all like about track 12. Is that one of the interesting songs that she did to make as a main title for the album? Please share. Alright, moving on. Track 13. Do It Well remix featuring Ludacris. Here we go, guys.
Do it, you do it, you do it, you're doing it well. Trying to look for anything. All of a sudden, couldn't take my eyes off you. I didn't even know if you could tell. gonna need a little privacy. I don't wanna do the dance, no, do-si-do. Need a grown woman man 7 days a week. Quit trying to play a cool boy, make you move. I told you how it is, nothing to lose. You can stay on over here all like a free. And I ain't taking cash or credit, just a guarantee. There ain't nobody else but me, boy.
You ain't even trying to play me, boy. You're so good, and you're so fine.
You be saying señorita. I love how you shake your distinctive features. My name's Ludacris and I'd like to freak it. They say, no para, I'll do it again. You know me, so I'm like, muy bien. I'm the numero uno, Rico Hombre. Baby, feel this and grito a mi nombre. Toda la noche, no you won't say. Skip the folk play, sip some rosé. Even add up the Juve Clico. And on that note, adios, amigos.
I don't need but my sweet senses.
Track 13, Do It Well remix. It's good that she put Ludacris on this song. And I say Ludacris was so iconic with his verse, and I actually feel his rap flow. And I say he was dynamite on this song. Y'all can tell me what y'all like about track 13. Is that one of the dopest songs that Ludacris did? I mean, that J-Lo did to put Ludacris on a remix version of her previous song, Do It Well. And y'all can let me know, like, is this one better than the original version with just her by herself? Or yes, like this one better because it got like more hip-hop music, pop, and a little bit of funk coming together with this remix version. Y'all really feel Ludacris being featured on the remix version of the song. Let me know your thoughts. Well, that's a wrap, everybody. We just reviewed all 13 tracks on this sixth album by J-Lo called Brave. I gotta say, this album is unique, and it's good I got a chance to check this album out when it was the year 2013 when I want to review the rest of her music, because I grew up on three of her albums, and I like to check out her later projects that she done that could be smash hits, and I give this album 100 stars. All the tracks are amazing, and it's good I got a chance to listen to how good this album is, even though J-Lo decided to return doing an English album after she released her Spanish album the same year, which was her fifth album in English called How a Woman Loves. And I will be reviewing that album soon for you guys, even though it's her first ever Spanish album that was produced by her then ex-husband Mark Anthony. And you all can let me know, like, what's your favorite tracks off of this album by Jennifer Lopez. Is this one of her best albums that came out when it was the year 2007? Because I think the album is interesting to listen to. And I'd say she got a good taste in music. And her vocals and her unique voice is so unique. And I really feel all the pop, R&B with this album, including hip-hop and funk and rock and electric dance music as well. And she has some interesting producers on this record to help her make the record more interesting to listen to. And y'all can let me know, like, how much y'all enjoy this album by Jennifer Lopez, and do y'all enjoy the two smash hit singles off the album, such as Do It Well, Hold It, Don't Drop It. Please share. Well, this is your boy Jay Bird, aka Mr. Cool Guy. That was my album review by Jennifer Lopez, reviewing her sixth album that came out when it was the year 2007, called Brave. Feel free to hit that subscribe button, tune to my later videos, check out more upcoming videos, like and subscribe to my channels. You all the best, I love you guys, and I wouldn't be here without y'all. Y'all the best, thank you for showing me love, and more videos will be coming y'all way soon, and let me know what y'all like about my previous videos, and give your boy a shout out when you review his channel. So y'all take it easy. I'll see y'all next time. Be easy, y'all. Deuces.